Hey everyone, Jess the nurse here. This is going to be a video on how to use an Epi Pen. So for this video, what I have to show you is the steps by looking at the training pen, and then this will be the actual Epi Pen. I'll show you that as well. So we're just going to go over the steps, a few simple instructions. So first off, with the training pen, so the way that you want to grip the pen is just like this, because you want to be sure that you are, this is the best way to hold it because you're going to inject it quickly and straight into the thigh. So with the training pen, there's instructions on it. You want to take off the blue cap on the top. For the actual one, there will be another cap here to take off. This orange part is demonstrating the part where it'll be red on the actual EpiPen, and then the needle would essentially eject as soon as you push this down into your thigh. So let's take a look at where do you want to inject this. The EpiPen should be injected deep into the muscle. So looking at, if you are injecting this for yourself, looking at your own thigh, you want to, looking from the top view from your knee to the top of your leg here, there is the middle third. And then if you divide it into thirds going across, you want to look at the right third of your thigh, right third, middle third, which will be here. Essentially the length of your arm should be, if you're making a fist, this is exactly where you want to inject it. So you've taken off the blue cap. You want to hold the EpiPen auto-injector like so. You're going to push down the orange tip or red tip where the needle will come out through, deep into the side muscle of your thigh. So quickly, and that click sound is to demonstrate that the needle has pierced through the muscle, has injected the medication, and you want to hold that in place for 5 to 10 seconds and then release. So let's take a look at the real EpiPen. So the instructions, this is for adults. So this is a 0.3 milligram epinephrine injection, auto injector. This is for allergic emergencies, where someone is demonstrating anaphylaxis. You probably heard in the news, someone had a peanut allergy, and with very severe allergies like to peanuts or to other things. Anaphylaxis is where someone is demonstrating swelling in the throat, difficulty breathing. It could be starting out as seeing an allergic reaction in the skin where you have hives that start to spread quickly until the swelling develops in the throat to where they can't breathe. So this is an emergency medication. If someone knows that they always get really itchy after eating a certain, fruit that they're allergic to, that's not a situation. If their throat is not swelling up, if it's not affecting their airway, that's not a situation where you're going to use an EpiPen. That would be a situation where you can use, you can just tell them, or if it's for yourself, to take a Benadryl, typically the 25 milligrams, or you can take two to equal 50 milligrams. You can also couple that with another medication like Claritin or Zyrtec. So one of those seasonal allergy pills that you've probably heard of, you can take that with a Benadryl. Or you can use a topical ointment like a hydrocortisone cream or something similar to that. So inside of this is for adults. If you have the one that's for children, it'll likely be less milligrams than that. So for patients weighing over 66 pounds, and just a few quick instructions I want to point out here. Protect it from heat and light. You do not refrigerate this. Replace it if you see that the solution is discolored, cloudy, or contains particles. You want to store it at room temperature, 68 to 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So now this is enclosed in a case. So you want to open this. It says twist and pull inside. And we'll see. So like I said, it'll have two coverings. You can see the solution through the middle. You want to make sure that it's not expired. It has an expiration date, February 2018. So what you would do is, and I'm not going to take this off just because we need to keep this for emergencies. So first I would pull the top part off, and the part where the needle is, when you pull this off, it will likely be red or orange underneath there. You'll pull that off. So pull the top, pull the back end, sorry, and then the top where the needle would be. I'm going to grip it like so. And then you're going to thrust it into the side of your thigh or the side of someone else's thigh if this is an emergency. And you'll hold it in place, you'll hear a click. The needle will go through the muscle, it will inject the medication, wait 5 to 10 seconds, and then release. And that's how you use an EpiPen. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next video.